Hi, my name is Nibin, and I'm part of the Identity Advanced Cloud Engineering team at Microsoft. As an admin, you might discover that Azure AD Connect service do not start. Part of this issue, you might also experience one of the symptoms such as Microsoft Azure Active Directory sync tool stops syncing, or you receive email message that Azure Active Directory didn't register synchronization attempt in the last 24 hours. Or it could be that when you try to open the MIIS client.exe tool, you will receive a stop server down error message. In this video, let's try to troubleshoot one of the most common scenarios that can cause Azure AD Connect service startup issues. Let's get started with what error that you will observe when you try to start the synchronization service or the MIIS client.exe tool when the Azure AD Connect service is having a service failure. As you can see on the screen, the Synchronization Service Manager reports the error, unable to connect to the synchronization service. And one of the possible reasons mentioned here, the service is not started. So we need to investigate the service startup problem. In order to do the same, let's open the services console on this server. You'll be looking for Microsoft Azure AD Sync service. As you can see here on the screen, Microsoft Azure AD Sync service, it's not running, which means it's having a problem right now. So in order to investigate that, I'm trying to start the service manually. And you can straight away see the service did not start due to a logon failure. So it seems there is a failure for this service because the logon account is having a problem logging onto the machine. So let's check what service account under which this service is running. Typically with Express installations, it will be an automatically created service account, but due to customizations in the enterprise environments, you will have corresponding service account from your Active Directory. You can find this account details in the logon tab. Here in my environment, there is a service account that's used from my domain. And this service account is having login problems to this Azure AD Connect server. The identified sync service account needs to have three mandatory user rights assignments on the sync server. User rights govern the methods by which a user can log on to a system. In order to demonstrate this, I will open the local security policy on the affected AD Connect server. I will go to start run gpedit.msc. This will open the local group policy editor. I need to expand computer configuration, Windows settings, security settings, local policies, user rights assignments. I will review three of these assignments one by one. The first one I would like to take a look is allow logon login. In my scenario, the users group is listed there, which includes all the other users. The second setting is logon as a batch job. As you can see, my AAD service account is already listed here under this privilege. The third privilege I'm looking for is logon as a service. And in my case, my service account is missing this privilege, and this could be my problem. So in order to solve this, I'm going to add my service account to this privilege. Typically, in an enterprise environment, these settings are applied through domain policies. But sometimes you might also find that these settings are set locally on the machine using group policy. If you make any changes to local policy or domain policy, restart the computer for the changes to take effect. Since I've assigned all the three privileges, I'm trying to now start this service to make sure that the service startup works fine. So, in my case, adding my service account into the required user rights assignment helps solve the problem. After you follow the above steps and confirm that AAD Sync service account does have all the required user rights on the machine, and if you still face service startup issues, then you may try to find and fix the problem by scanning the application and system event logs to identify some of the events that Azure AD Connect application or service generates. Typically, they have event sources as directory synchronization or AD sync. This may also give you an idea of why the service is not starting up. I hope this video helps you with your investigation. Thanks for watching.